Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather all around. Scan tools, lots of different ones out there. I've tried quite a few, I own quite a few. The school has a bunch of them as well. I'm gonna be looking today at this one, which is the ANCEL BD310. Let's go! So I've never played with a scan tool quite like this one before. It's a little different, it's small, it Bluetooths to your phone, but it does have a screen on here. It's already got a cable and a plug that you can plug right into your car. So I've got down here, I've got my little this, and then this guy plugs into your OBD2. 1996 and newer is pretty much all standardized OBD2. So whatever car you have, you probably have a plug like this somewhere down by your kneecaps, so you can put this all in and make it work. So we're gonna plug that in. Dink, that's in. Most scan tools come with instructions that can tell you a lot of neat stuff. This one is pretty simple, just tells you what the buttons do. Sorry, I had that in Bluetooth mode. So I'm gonna turn the key on. It's gonna dingy dingy. No dingy dingy. So when I first plugged this in, it was in ordinary mode. I got a button on the side to Bluetooth it to my phone, and there's an app that you can download. I'm not always a big fan of apps. I'm a bit of a security freak, got the tinfoil hat going on and everything, but it does give you a whole lot more with the app on your phone. And we've got different things we can go on here, and basically, I can go up and down, setup, and you can change the language if you want metric or American. We've got, I guess, give feedback, tool information, kind of cool. I wonder what tool information is. Oh, just tells me what we got there. Okay, back. And the keypad thing here is pretty easy to figure out. I mean, it's not rocket surgery here. I like that. I like a tool that is easy to figure out. So the meter. So the meter kind of thing, you've got a couple different screens you can put on there, see if we can make that look decent for you. It's a bunch of different stuff you can have on the screen while you're driving. And I guess it's looking at stuff that's not actually moving. Like, I'm not actually moving. Cool feature with this, it comes with this kind of like stick it in your vent kind of magnet thing, which will stick to the back of that. And I can put that in the vents of my car, like right here. And that thing will stick, and then I can watch it while I'm driving, which is kind of handy. And you can go up to OBD2, and it'll connect, and it'll look at if you got any check engine lights, what's kind of going on, and it'll talk to your car in a variety of different ways. You can even go data stream and see what your car is doing on here. Let's fire the car up and see what it's going to do with that. So the Bluetooth button is up there. It tells you're in Bluetooth mode, which is always handy. Reminds you to download the app. Let's play with the app. I have the volume turned down a little bit here because we got the engine running, which is pretty quiet. But I also have the exhaust fans going so I don't die, which would make for an interesting video. I like scan tools that will show a graph of what's going on. I mean, maybe you got something weird going on with your vehicle and I want to look for hiccups in things. I get my students to look at oxygen sensors and throttle position sensors, which are pretty common to fail and can certainly present some drivability sort of issues. Plus, they're easy to get to and easy to test for kids to learn how to use them. O2 voltage, you can see this thing cycling rich and lean and rich and lean and rich and lean all around 0.47 of a volt, which shows that it is working. It kind of shows that you're in closed loop and it's tuning itself as you drive. Lots of stuff you can play with in here. Throttle position, that's always a good one. This is checking the voltage going into the PCM or ECU. This is kind of representing the load of your engine, sort of related to the volumetric efficiency table in the computer, but that's another chat.
Here, if the voltage doesn't match your foot, you know you've got a problem with the throttle position sensor. Curiously, it says it's minus 3 degrees outside, but I don't have an ambient air temperature in this car, so there you are. Has a lot of the stuff that you want to look at, much like most of the useful scan tools out there. And I do love that it has a chart for pretty near everything that it gives you, and you can see what's actually happening. So I don't have any current trouble codes on this vehicle, which is kind of nice. You can clear them if you had them, but if you still have the issue, those codes will still come back. And this is looking at the emission controls and seeing if you're ready, but I'm not actually driving it, so it hasn't finished all of its official tests. I did do this after having taken it for a drive, so it would complete all of its tests, but I don't know if I show it for you here. Chances are, if you're buying a scan tool, it's because your vehicle has some issues. This at least can help you find them. Gives you quite a lot of data on the oxygen sensors, plus also quite a few other tests that you can make it go through. Gives you quite a bit of data. This one you need to drive it. So, I borrowed one of my kids and we went for a short little drive. Didn't check to see. Looks like you can change the speed you want to get up to. I went to 60 kilometers an hour because I don't need to get a ticket. And then it just records their time and gives you a bunch of other data in there that maybe you've made alterations to your vehicle and you want to make sure it made a difference. It's kind of useful. Dashboard's kind of handy. If you have a dash mount for your phone, you can have big versions of the gauges to show you what you're measuring while you're driving along. Now, it's got a heads-up display, depending on the brightness of your phone. So if you can Velcro or tape or nail gun your phone to the dashboard of your car, this thing will shine up and reflect on the windshield. Kind of interesting. This is what it's like with the headlights on. A little less interesting, but it's easier to drive with the headlights on than in pitch black. Battery check's kind of cool. One of the ways you can check the strength of your battery is just to crank it or load test the battery and see if you drop below 9.7 volts. Tells you kind of what you're looking for, what kind of voltages are acceptable. It certainly knows that the engine's running, so you turn that off. And then you crank it. And we see if it's any good. And I've tested the battery on this car a number of times. I'm probably going to be replacing it next year. So we're down to 9.72 volts, which is a little bit low. I'll load test it just to make sure, but I'll replace it before it leaves me stranded somewhere. And then it gives you a bunch of reports that it saves as a PDF that you can share with your friends, or download, or email, or whatever. This is just the vehicle inspection one. Again, I just fired it up. I didn't go driving, so that's why we've got a lot of unfinished tests, because it needs to drive to complete those tests. And it gives you all the data that's recorded in that.
So we checked out the ANCEL BD310 scan tool. Sticks to your dashboard, gives you a little bit of a display on there, can reset codes, check codes, probably not in that order. It'll Bluetooth to your phone, it can give you a heads up display if you're into that kind of thing. Shows you a lot of data, gives you some performance data if you're into that. Whether you've got issues with your vehicle or not, this can certainly keep you abreast of what's going on with your little vehicle there as well. So kind of cool. If it intrigues you, there's a link down below, probably a discount code as well. May you have no problems with your vehicles, and if you do, you can find, right in the face, you can find them and delete them as well, which is kind of handy. So thanks for watching. As always, take care, and we'll see you again.